the whole origin of this is the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda, where under Article 28, Clause 3, it is stated that any person who is arrested of any offence is presumed to be innocent until evidence has been laid to prove that he's guilty or that person has on his own admitted committing the offence. So that is the background. Presumed innocence means whatever offence you have been charged with, until the evidence is brought to court and you are found to have committed that offence, you are still presumed to be innocent. And that is the our system which we operate under in Uganda. In some countries, they can say you are guilty until you prove your what? Until you prove your innocence. That becomes a different system. But ours is presuming everyone to be innocent until the person has pleaded guilty or has been proved to be guilty. Now, against that background, there come in that other provision which provides that a person who is charged with any offense is entitled to apply for bail. And when it states that, it does not segregate. It says any person charged with a criminal offense can apply for bail. Now, it's then the court to which he has applied or she has applied has the duty to look at the circumstances of the case, the nature of the offense. And now that's when the issue of capital offense, like murder, rape, aggravated defilement, the offenses of treason. That's now we start classifying them according to the seriousness of the offense. So the court to which they have applied now has the duty to look at what offense was committed, in which the bail is being applied. So now the court will analyze the circumstances of each case differently. And either that court may grant the bail or may not grant the bail, depending on what has been put before it. So that one now shows you that there is no category of offenses which are barred from being applied for bail under the Constitution. It's only now the discretion of court depending on the seriousness of the offense. Possibly where the issue comes in, where people is where they feel that some offenses shouldn't be granted bail, like murder, like treason. So that's now where it varies. But the background of the law is that in every offense, a person can apply for bail. So that is the background under which all this is coming from. The presumption of innocence, because of course the presumption of innocence is that in case you have been arrested and charged, and it is later found out that you didn't commit the crime, if you had been granted bail, you will not feel that pinch. But if you are innocent and you have been on remand for a very long time, and then they find that you never committed the crime, that means you have suffered for nothing. You have suffered for nothing. Yes, the law may allow you to sue the state for compensation, but that's another long procedure now. So that's the background under which this bail is incorporated in our laws. When it is considering that bail application, there can be issues of compromising the witnesses, the threatening of witnesses. In some cases, witnesses have disappeared. And normally it is at the hand of their accused who has been granted bail. So all those issues are supposed to be put on the table of court before it grants bail, and it analyzes them. If it finds that releasing this person on bail will compromise the witnesses, will jeopardize the investigations. Then the court can base on that and not and doesn't grant bail. But in some cases, you may find they have not raised that issue. If it has not been raised, it means it's not an issue, and the court cannot on its own start thinking that he was going to certain witnesses. So granting someone bail doesn't mean that he's innocent. No. He's still presumed. You know, presumption doesn't mean that you are innocent. It means that you are looked at as it is, at this stage, you are looked at as innocent. But the evidence can come and prove otherwise. So it doesn't mean that when a person has been released on bail, they have found him not have, you know, they have found that there is no evidence against him or what. No. The person is still unaccused. He's only allowed to attend to his case while coming from outside. And the other consideration court considers is, the biggest one, is if we release this person on bail, is he coming back to attend his trial? That is the primary thing. Because once court is convinced that once you are granted bail, you will disappear, then it can't grant you bail. But if it is convinced that you are a person who will come back and evidence is laid against you, if you are found guilty, you are punished accordingly, then the court will grant you the bail. Because you are not innocent. You are yet to come back and be proved to be either innocent or guilty. When a person has appeared in court, and if it's a capital offense, definitely those people appear in courts which have no jurisdiction to hear their cases. That is the magistrate's courts. That is the first point where they go. So they read to them the charges. You have a right to know why you have been arrested and what offense have you been charged with. So the magistrate will read those charges to the person, and normally what we hear is, I do not have jurisdiction to handle your case. If you want bail, you will apply to High Court. They remand that person in prison. Now, but they also explain that you have a right to apply for what? For bail. You are entitled to apply for bail in the High Court. You are entitled to apply for bail in the High Court. So you go on remand. If you want to apply for bail, you will now apply for bail where they have advised you to go, and that is High Court. So that person might apply for bail or might not. If he applies for bail, the court will now examine what he has put on the table and either grant or not grant. If he doesn't apply for bail, it means he's going to be on remand as investigations are ongoing. Now, the investigations, if they are not complete in a capital offense is like murder, rape, and the rest, within 180 days, while you are on remand and they have not completed investigations, the same constitution again comes in and says that person should be granted bail. Now, that bail is the easy one because you already have finished 180 days. They have not laid any evidence against you, much as they may be still going on investigating. That one is easy. You may even be granted bail without a surety. You may not be asked to pay anything. Court will just grant you bail after 180 days. If it is an offense which is these simple offenses of theft, assault, if you have finished 60 days and they have not brought any witness to court to show that they are ready to prosecute you, then you can also be granted bail without those stringent measures put in place. So in essence, if you don't apply for bail in a capital offense, you are supposed to spend 180 days. In other offenses, 60 days. But if you apply for bail in either of those offenses, then the court now has a duty to look at what you have presented and considers the circumstances that have been put there, and it either grants bail or it doesn't. If it does not, then you fall back to the other 180 days and 60 days.